Hey everybody, and welcome to This Week in Horror. So this is gonna be a weekly segment on Morbidly Beautiful's YouTube channel, hosted by yours truly, where we're just gonna go over some of the big headlines in horror for the week. This video might be a little bit longer than I'm anticipating the following videos to be. My idea is I kinda wanna keep them a little bit short, not go on too long, talk about too many stories, because I assume most of you out there are like me, and I don't really have time, or unfortunately the patience, to sit and watch the news at all. Like, I can't sit and watch an hour-long news thing. I got stuff to do. That's gonna kind of be the idea around the weekly horror news segments. I'm gonna try and keep them a little bit short. You can get the gist of what's going on in the horror world for the week and go about your day. Even though we like creepy and gory things, horror teaches us to celebrate life. We celebrate the final girls or final boys that make it to the end of the horror movie and defeat the killer. So I figure we can celebrate some birthdays that are happening in the horror community this week. On March 16th, you can say happy birthday to Alexandra Daddario. She was the star of Texas Chainsaw 3D. Not my favorite out of the Chainsaw franchise, but you can still say happy birthday to her anyway. Also say happy birthday to Gore Verbinski. Verbinski directed such films as A Cure for Wellness, the American remake of The Ring, which in my opinion is probably the best American remake of a Japanese horror movie. And then on the 17th, St. Patrick's Day, you can shoot a happy birthday to Mr. Kurt Russell, whose work spans tons of genres, but when he does do the horror genre, he does do it well. And then on the more morbid side, the 17th of March also gave us John Wayne Gacy. Lucky us. And as horror fans, not only do we have an appreciation for life, but we also celebrate and respect death. Which leads me to our next segment, Happy Death Day. So on March 13th, we lost the master of gore himself, Lucio Fulci. Then Beware the Ides of Marge. On March 15th, we lost Julius Caesar. We also lost horror sci-fi writing icon, H.P. Lovecraft. Then, of course, on March 17th, St. Patrick, according to legend, died so that we could enjoy green beer. Happy St. Patrick's Day. All right, now on to the headlines for the week. So The Strangers Pray at Night opened this weekend to a whopping $10 million its opening weekend. Not so bad for a movie that cost about $5 million for its budget, but not as much as A Wrinkle in Time, which made a little more than $30 million on its opening weekend. Next, a little South by Southwest news. Blumhouse released a secret sequel to Unfriended on the South by Southwest audience called Unfriended Dark Web. The film is about a teen who comes into possession of a new laptop and soon discovers that the previous owner is not only watching him, but will also do anything to get it back. Like its predecessor, Unfriended Dark Web is going to take place in real time, completely on a laptop screen. Hopefully we'll get a wide release soon. I couldn't find any information about when that would be, but I will keep you guys posted. Next, A Quiet Place also premiered at South by Southwest. Written, directed by, and starring The Office's John Krasinski, A Quiet Place is about a family living in isolation and utter silence for fear of an unknown threat that follows and attacks at any sound. And it looks like Krasinski's horror feature film directorial debut is going really well. Right now on IMDb, it has an 8.6 out of 10. On Rotten Tomatoes, it has 100% critics rating, and on Roger Ebert, it has a 3.5 out of 4. So it's doing really well, and it's set to be released to a wide audience on April 6th. Next, Guillermo del Toro fans rejoice. The Shape of Water is coming to DVD on the 13th. And finally, a little bit of Halloween watch. This past week, Jason Blum tweeted that the first cut of the new Halloween sequel coming out this October should be ready in about 6 weeks. That tells us that post-production is going really well, and it looks like we are set for its release date later this year. That's all I have for you this week in horror. If I missed any stories, please let me know in the comments. Let me know what you think about the headlines this week. Are you excited for Unfriended Dark Web? Are you excited for A Quiet Place? Are you gonna be buying The Shape of Water on DVD? Things I wanna know in that comment section. A wonderful and scary week, creeps, and until next time, stay strange. Bye.